this Loop squad is doing pretty damn good, especially considering now that Dadin, their IGL, is no longer with them. That's a tough transition to make mid-tournament, and so far, being able to still show that they're able to accomplish big things here.
And that's honestly what they have to do. They have to prove to the world, okay, there might have been some changes on the team, but we're still Loops. We are still that team that came from the Americas region at the top, and we are going to come into this world stage and dominate, baby. So RRQ trying to toss out some smoke so that Beer can reposition to that boulder right on over there, but they are going to be spotted. Those toes,
That was so huge. That was so huge. That's going to allow them to push up big time, and you can just see instantly they're going to be sending it straight to that rock. They're gonna park it right there, get the confirm onto G9, and worry about RRQ coming up closer. This is why Loops, Bigatron, teams like this are so strong at being able to just push up little by little just using their gun skill.
Power Triple Eight to the north will also be pushing onto Team Secret as we see them in the kill feed.
Oh, Loops, what a nade!
Loops taking down RRQ, saying, "This is my boulder, thank you very much."
Loops are just going straight goat mode right now after that one. Team Secret has taken out in fourth. Still, fifth place. Good game finish for them. As Alpha 7, he's got eyes locked onto Power Triple Eight. And you can just see the full spray just putting on that pressure. Not allow ICE to be able to get his teammate up right now. And you can just see the full spread right now. The issue is, look at the circle. The circle is in between all of them, and there is zero cover there. Loops, they're just gonna have to either send it in that dossier, park it, and then lay down, or just try to do it with their gun skill.
I think Loops, they see the crate right there on the edge. I think get into those dossiers, they are gonna be smoking, but send them both, blow them up, and then use that crate for cover right there on the edge. Alpha 7, they are gonna be pushing on into the play zone. Like you said, though, it is bare. There's not much to work with right here.
Well, the thing is that Power Triple Eight are going to have the advantage of being closer to the circle than anybody else, and they're going to be using that to their advantage big time because they can see everybody right now. But Kowalski is going to put some pressure onto those nades as well, getting too close for comfort.
Get to.
Not hitting the mark. What a push. He's pushing up to confirm the rest of his squad. Oh, and he catches Bennett out as well. Corpi is going to shut him down, though, from Power Triple Eight. There's just knocks going on in every direction here.
A 2v3v1. Alpha 7, they got their two members behind that tree.
The stun
will be blinding them, and the spray with the Uzi actually connecting.
A blind Uzi spray catching those two members from Power Triple Eight. And now you can see, Alpha 7 in big trouble right now. It's just Vit2K by his lonesome. You know he wishes he had some more nades in his hands. Does he got one? Let's see if he's going to be able to hit this. Can he do it? Oh,
up,
it's okay. 4-3.
Bounce!
What's just too close off the rim? And he's going to get shut down by
Kowalski.
The nade. He died before it went off and it negated it. What an insane finish. Power Triple Eight able to get a match.